Hello Chaos people, my name is Yordan and I'm a 3D artist at Chaos. Watch this tutorial to learn how to set up amazing daytime lighting for your exterior renderings. If you want to follow along, you can find the scene in the description below. First, let's start an interactive renderer from V-Ray's toolbar. Currently, the render is completely black, because we don't have any sources of light in the scene yet. To change that, create a V-Ray sun from the toolbar and place it somewhere in the scene. V-Ray will then ask us if we want to automatically add a V-Ray sky environment map. I will click yes, since this will help us simulate realistic outdoor lighting as the V-Ray sky texture adjusts its appearance depending on the position of the V-Ray sun without having to tweak additional parameters. Now, you can see we have some light in the scene, but it still looks too dark. That is because our sun is too low and the lighting is closer to night than day. Let's bring the sun a bit higher on the Z-axis. While setting up lights, I like to take out all distractions from my render and focus only on the lighting. One way to do this is by going into render settings, global switches, and enabling material override. A much quicker way is to turn on debug shading in the VFB and select lighting. That way, everything in our scene will temporarily adopt a gray, non-reflective material, which makes our lighting much more readable. Other uses for debug shading are examining wireframes, texture coordinates, face normals, and much more. Okay. Now, we are ready to tweak the light coming from the sun. Just move the sun gizmo and the sky will update automatically. That way, we can quickly iterate through different scenarios and achieve the result that we like. Once we have our general light direction, I would like to adjust the sharpness of the shadows. This is easily done by tweaking the sun size parameter. A larger value will make the sun disk bigger and the shadows softer. Let's focus on a part of the image where we can observe the cast shadows from the sun by drawing a render region around it and zooming in a little. Now that we have a better view of what we want to tweak, we can proceed adjusting the sun size value. For this scene, I think a value of 3 or 4 looks nice, so I will stick with that. Now that we have our lighting set, we can disable the render region and debug shading, so that we can see how our scene will look with materials and colors. Using the V-Ray sun and sky system, we can push realism even further by enabling clouds inside V-Ray sun's parameters. This will create procedural clouds that can be tweaked, animated, and even cast shadows onto our image. For this image, I want a rather clear sky, so I will use a lower value on the density, and to make the clouds be less uniform, I will also bring up the variety parameter. Feel free to tweak those numbers to your liking. Another important pair of settings for the overall appearance of the sky are the cloud's height and thickness. Sticking to the fairly clear sky look that I'm going for this image, I will bring those values down a bit. Also, usually there are different layers of clouds in the real world that have a different look and are at different heights. To simulate this in V-Ray's procedural sun and sky system, we can play with the cirrus amount value, which will be responsible for the highest layer of clouds. Lower values will make that layer much less prominent, and a higher value will bring more clouds in the sky. For this case, I think a value of 0.7 looks good. Another approach to lighting an exterior scene in V-Ray is using HDRI panorama images. For this approach, let's select the dome light from the toolbar and place it somewhere in the scene. Starting the IPR, everything seems dark and gray at the moment, because the dome light is using only a solid color and we need to feed it a texture. Let's open up the material editor and navigate to Maps, V-Ray, V-Ray Bitmap. Then load in an HDRI panorama image. If you don't have any, you can download free ones from polyheaven.com or other similar sources. I will use one from my library, named Evening. Because it is a 360 degree panorama image, we also need to switch the mapping type to spherical, rather than the default setting. Now, let's just click and drag that to the dome light's texture slot. You'll immediately see a change in the lighting, but overall, the image is way too dark. One way to fix this is to change the intensity of the dome light. Something around 50 works well for this particular HDRI. The great thing about HDRIs is that now we can simply rotate the texture from the material editor to achieve different lighting results for our scene. By swapping different HDRIs, you can continue experimenting and achieve different moods for your image. Another great source for HDRIs is Chaos Cosmos. Let's open the Chaos Cosmos browser from the toolbar and go to the HDRI section. Here, you can find a variety of day, night, and studio HDRIs for any type of scene you're creating. Using them is pretty straightforward. Just download the ones that you like and want to test with your scene. For easier navigation, I will click Downloaded so to display only the HDRIs that I have previously selected. Out of them, I really like the Sunset 16 HDRI. To load it into the project, you can either double-click it or drag and drop it into the material editor. Then, plug it into the dome light. Keep in mind that different HDRIs might require tweaking the dome light's intensity. Now, to further tweak the lighting, I can change the texture rotation. But to make things more handy, we can go to the dome light settings and enable lock texture to icon. That way, to adjust the position of the HDRI, all we have to do is rotate the dome light gizmo in the viewport. I find this workflow much more convenient. Alright, let's disable debug shading so that we can see the materials in our scene and render out the image for a moment to see how the lighting looks overall. Great, I like the results, so let's prepare our settings for production rendering. I will stop the IPR, open the V-Ray settings and adjust the resolution. Then, from the V-Ray tab, let's change the sampler to Bucket instead of Progressive. Furthermore, we can lower the noise threshold to 0.007 for a really crisp and clean image. Okay, when you're ready, go ahead and click Render. Keep in mind that no image sampling method is best, and each finds its uses. Progressive sampling has a great advantage as it refines the image sequentially, and you can stop the rendering process if you're happy with the achieved quality, regardless if rendering is complete. On the other hand, bucket sampling finds its place in production renders as it is more memory efficient and also will not lose information if you're using distributed rendering and one of your servers crashes. Once the rendering is complete, don't forget to save your final image from the save icon in the VFB and choose the location and file format to save your render. Now that you've learned how to set up daylighting for your renders, feel free to check out the rest of our tutorials for V-Ray for 3ds Max.